Hey cigar smokers, Matt Urbano, Urbano Cigars. Got another 101 on going on for you here. I actually wanted to show you, right, how to store your cigars in a humidor. I've got a Tupperware container here. I've got my desktop humidor. Then I've got some actual cigar boxes here. Then I've got old technology, and then I've got new technology, and then just, you know, kind of what not to store your cigars in. So, you know, humidors are awesome, but they're wicked expensive. There's a lot of other substitutes you can use, right? This is like a plastic container. It's, you know, airtight. It clips on. It's really great. As we look at this here, you can just see that I've got a couple boxes of cigars here. Okay, just storing them in here. If this is too big, if you're not a box guy and you're you buy a lot of singles or a lot of different types of sample packs and things, we can always use a much smaller container. And then the cigar box. The cigar box really is not ideal to store cigars in, right? It's made of cedar, most of them are anyway. But it's just not airtight. What you really want to look for is a container that is airtight. If you have a quality humidor, when you lift and then close the humidor, you should hear like a little bit of a suction sound, okay? So that's the main thing. What we're trying to do is we're trying to control the climate within the humidor. Ideally, you want to be at 70% humidity and then 70 degrees Fahrenheit. So 70-70 is a good rule. As far as actually using different types of material to keep your box hydrated, the number one thing is do not use tap water, okay? You actually have to use distilled water or a solution you buy at your tobacconist to actually apply to your medium. The medium is going to be whatever you're going to use to hold the water or hold the liquid. Personally, I use distilled water. I always think, you know, I personally don't want to use a chemical that is, I'm going to put something in my mouth and then smoke it. I want to actually try to keep the cigar as pure as possible. I hope you can read this. This is a gallon bottle. I'm not getting anything from Crystal Light. I just want you to see that it's actually a distilled product, okay? Distillation is purification of the water. You heat it up, you boil the water, they catch the steam turns into distilled water when it cools. All the impurities in the water actually stay in the vessel they use to heat up the water. Now, years ago, when I started smoking, I didn't have a humidor. I used Tupperware constantly. Tupperware works perfect, or some type of plastic container that's airtight. What I used to always use was some type of little cup, tray, ramekin, shot glass, something like that. And then what I do is I put in a slightly damp paper towel. I wet it with the distilled water and then I wring it out really good, and then it's just damp. You want to be 70% humidity. If the humidor or the box you're storing in is too damp, what's going to happen is your cigars are going to mold. All right. If you're using a paper towel, you have to change that out weekly because you don't want the paper towel to actually mold. All right. So this is like the most affordable way to store your cigars. Airtight plastic container, depending on the amount of cigars, would be, you know, obviously the size of the container. I would not put 15 cigars in here. I would get a much smaller container, and you can use the little bowl with the paper towel and the distilled water. As far as old technology goes, this is the thing that clips on the top of the humidor. It is filled with this green floral foam, right? You can get this floral foam at like any craft store. I used to go and get it from the florist. You only need a small amount. If you open the thing that is on top of your humidor, you'll actually see that the same green foam is here, okay? Now, very important, you're talking drops of water, right? You're not talking saturate this thing. If you saturate this, you're gonna get your cigars moldy and you may possibly even get them wet, which will discolor the wrapper and will hurt the cigar. They can always dry out, but your wrapper on your cigar will be stained. So this is what I would consider older technology. It works just fine, but you have to open this regularly and make sure there's no mold in here, okay? So that's the thing I always say to everybody is the foam is good, but you gotta keep an eyeball on it. Obviously, you would cut this down to size to fit in the container. If your humidor came with something, you need to cut it down to size to fit. The other thing you could do is cut this down to size and just put it in a little cup, a little bowl or something like that. And again, you want this damp. You don't want it wet. If it's wet, you're gonna damage your product, your cigars at the end of the day. Now, as far as new technology, what I really like are these crystal beads. You can get these from us off of our website. These come already with liquid in them. What I love about these, I use these constantly, is it tells you, there's a little gauge on the side of the container here, and what'll happen is these are gonna shrink and they're gonna also swell, right? So when they start to dry out, they're gonna shrink, and then you just put a little bit of distilled water in, and then you're gonna see they're gonna get bigger again and they're gonna absorb that. The thing that's nice about this is if you use distilled water, you'll easily get 6 months out of this. What I like about it is it can regulate the inside of your humidor. If your box is a little dry, it's gonna give moisture off. If your box is a little wet, the beads are gonna actually pull moisture in, okay? Another good avenue or good way to store your cigars if you're just starting out, if you don't have Tupperware, you may just have a box. A box is not ideal, as I said earlier. This is a new product that I've used. I travel a lot with cigars. I've got the cigars out, you know, in sometimes not perfect circumstances. So I'll use this. This is beautiful. This comes in different sizes. This is the gel beads in a container. So you put a little bit of distilled water on them. You have to take one cigar out. All right. Got to smoke this one, unfortunately, right? And then this fits in. Just make sure that before you buy this, these happen to be Churchill's. This is 8 inches long, 48 ring gauge. This will actually fit in this box. As a lot of you guys know, torpedoes are my favorite. This torpedo is 6x52. This is just a smidge too long to fit in a six inch box. You know, so if you try to put this in, you're not gonna be able to close it. So just kind of pay attention to the size of the stick. This is called a gel stick or a humus stick or something like that. I have not activated this yet. You can hear the beads are dry, okay? So what you do is put a couple of good drops of distilled water in, kind of check it out. You may need to put a little bit more distilled water in. The big thing here is do not overfill this and make sure you dry it off with a paper towel before you put it in your box. These cigars happen to be in cellophane, right? But even though they're in cellophane, the cellophane can get a little funny. And then lastly, this is like an envelope filled with beads, all right? So this is a great product, okay? This will last for probably about 3 to maybe 5 months or so. This is something that you are not supposed to refill. You can see on the back here, it's like a paper envelope with the beads inside it. Just take this and you can actually put it inside and then you can close the lid, okay? And then go from there. If you have a smaller Tupperware container, same thing, right? This will actually, you can put this or maybe one or two of these inside the Tupperware. If you have just a Ziploc bag works great, but you have to introduce some moisture in. This is the same thing, the beads. This is going to be able to read the humidity inside the box, the container or the Ziploc bag. It's gonna give off moisture and then pull in moisture. So, you know, you could just put this right inside your Ziploc bag and go from there. You don't need to go out and spend a fortune on these big expensive humidors in the beginning. It's more of something that just helps you enjoy cigars more as time goes on. So you can always start out with Tupperware or just an old cigar box. make sure you've got something in there. As far as humostats, the thing, either some cigar box, some humidors have it on the front of the box, some have it on the lid. That spring dial looks like an old style clock. I found personally those usually are not that accurate. I like to use a digital hydrometer. Digital is more accurate and you'll actually see it moves. If your box isn't right and you just can't get the humidity to be right in there, 70% humidity, 70 degrees Fahrenheit, move this around your house a little bit, okay? If you're on an outside wall and you're getting a lot of sun exposure on there, maybe too cool. If you're on an inside wall and you have central air conditioning or just near your AC unit, maybe the room is a little too cool. So they say 70-70. There's a lot of different things. And I just want to remind everybody, if you're going to use the green foam, keep an eyeball on there. Make sure it's not getting old and moldy. If it's moldy, throw it out. This is so cheap. It's unbelievable. This is a couple of dollars. You can get several cuts to refill this. You could probably easily five, maybe eight times as far as trimming it down. And then the beads are my favorite. You're using the paper towel method, make sure it's damp and not wet, and always make sure you have distilled water. Never go over to the kitchen sink and just flip on the faucet and use that water. You're gonna get a mold problem really, really fast. Hope this helps, and if you like these 101s, please subscribe to our YouTube channel or follow us on our blog. You can subscribe on the blog as well, and then I'll be able to answer your questions. Enjoy your cigars. Hope this helps with your humidors.